The names of the Pac-Man ghosts are confusing. So confusing, in fact, that the developers of this game cut them wrong, too. Who's that piloting Blinky's frog? It's Clyde. Clyde is piloting Blinky's frog. Yeah. Since even the devs couldn't get their names right, I looked up their correct names, and in the process, I learned something new. I learned that each ghost has a personality. They act differently and chase Pac-Man in different ways. That may not come as a shock to many of you, but what comes next probably will. After learning this, I rewatched the opening cutscene of this game, and I was shocked by what I saw. Pinky the Pink attempts to stay in front of Pac-Man. That personality can also be interpreted as wanting his attention, which explains why Pinky is often portrayed as having a crush on Pac-Man. Of course, in the cutscene, she would be spying on him while he sleeps, dismembering an innocent flower in a game of he loves me not. Blinky the Red is aggressive, chasing you even when you have a power pellet. Of course, he plays the role of the troublemaker, being the one to suggest that all of the ghosts pick the golden fruit in the opening cutscene. Clyde the Orange is my favorite, because he's a dimwit. He misses the point and wanders the map in a random fashion, and that is exactly what we see here. The best part is that he also misses the point of being a ghost, because he's, well, I was going to say he's scared of his own shadow, but in this case, it's the shadow of this tree. I will give poor old Clyde a pass on this one though, because not only is this tree mysteriously absent in the morning, but it's also levitating above the ground? Yeah, hopefully we won't be encountering any evil trees later on in this game. Taru Iwatani, the creator of Pac-Man, claims that Inky the Blue, Inky the Cyan, I honestly don't know how to say the word cyan, and so in my notes I just wrote Inky the Blue. Anyway, Taru claims that Inky the Blue has the same exact behavior as Pinky, but strangely the code doesn't support the creator's claim. Inky is unpredictable because of his technicalities in the game's code. Without delving too deep, I will summarize and say that Inky looks two tiles ahead of Pac-Man, and then draws a vector from Blinky past that point. His decisions seem random, with his routes taking him on wild rides through the map, but that's because his movement is based on Blinky, not necessarily on Pac-Man. This blew me away because we actually see that technicality in the opening cutscene. Not only is his movement entirely dependent upon Blinky, but because of Blinky's actions, he goes on a wild ride through the village. It's crazy that the cutscene is that deep. And I figured that since I have gone through and talked about the ghost's technicalities this much, I might as well round that out a little bit. Taru Iwatani said this: "To give the game some tension, I wanted the monsters to surround Pac-Man at some stage of the game, but I felt it would be too stressful for your human being like Pac-Man to be continually surrounded and hunted down. So I created the monsters' invasions to come in waves. They would attack, and then they would retreat. As time went by, they would regroup, attack, and disperse again. It seemed more natural than having constant attack." The ghosts have three behaviors: chase, scatter, and frightened. Why do I feel like I'm talking about Five Nights at Freddy's? The first two modes alternate when an internal timer tells them to. This is how the difficulty of the game is determined. The scatter timer will get shorter and shorter, and the chase timer will become longer. As you can see, the timers also get more difficult as a single level progresses. The game also leverages difficulty by increasing Blinky's speed once an arbitrary pack dot milestone is met. This, for some reason, which I think has been lost to time, is known as Cruise Elroy mode. They are also programmed to never reverse their direction of travel unless they are switching from scatter to chase or vice versa. Experienced players will watch the ghosts and take note of when they pull a 180. I've even found myself playing around their AI as I play through the Galaxian levels. For example, Pinky always targets an area four tiles ahead of Pac-Man, so I'll often turn towards her knowing that she'll chicken out and take a different path than the one I'm heading on. It's really turned a simple arcade game that I used to grow bored of after a few rounds into a complex mental process of micro-decisions and AI manipulation. I respect it a lot more now, and I hope that you do too.